Kreegan Alliance. Obtain the ever-smoking Ring of Sulfur for the Kreegans to win the scenario. However, if Sandro is defeated in combat, the scenario is lost. Heroes are limited to level 24, but Sandro and three of his lieutenants will carry their experience, skills, and spells onto the next scenario. Now, that's actually a lie. You don't carry your lieutenants onto the final scenario for whatever reason. Equestrians, Wraiths, Wooden Ore. I'm pretty sure Equestrians are right there in the starting zone, to be perfectly honest. I'll actually take Wooden Ore. I want to get off to a quick start. As you can see, it's a small map, and you're very limited in what you're actually able to do. The Kreegans do not believe your sincerity. To them, necromancers are weak wraiths, feeding off the living, unable to initiate any good plan. To prove your sincerity, they want you to turn over the ever-smoking Ring of Sulfur. The druid stole it some years ago, and they want it back.
Kreegans are so arrogant, but I have need of their creatures to invade Arathia and crush her military. Without their brute strength, I would not be able to carry out all my plans. So I will play their little game and find their precious artifact, the ever-smoking Ring of Sulfur.
It's funny, because the Kreegans barely do anything in the Arathian. The Kreegans have demanded that the Necromancers prove their worth by hunting down the ever-smoking Ring of Sulfur. They apparently need this item to construct some of their buildings, although to the Necromancers it is a mere token. You have been sent to fetch this particular item personally because Phineas doesn't trust anyone else with the task. Kreegan support is essential to the plans of Deja. So here we are. We have Sandro, Isra, Vidomina. I forgot to get one last level up, oh well. And King Stannis the Manus. Alright, Pudik, thanks. Thank you very much for coming. See you next time. So here's where we begin. Alright, Azza, thank you as well. Have a good night. I'll even take the ballista. Isra and Vidomina will be doing the majority of the fights to start off, since they can actually get more skeletons than Sandra. Would I invade Arathia's tender nether regions? That just sounds wrong. Death Ripple! Death Ripple! Hey, Justin, my American? Yes, but I spell it with an E. M-E-R-I-C-A-C-A-N. What a shame. Could slow though. Yeah, well, I had to make sure they didn't actually reach. Right, through the garrison. Really? This is a winnable fight with our spells. Oh, they know what my plan is. try that again. Alright, they didn't resist. 63 skeletons. I believe there actually is a magic well on this side, which is to the good. Hoping there's a gold mine as well, or we're in trouble. Trying to clump them up on purpose. I guess we won't get so lucky, so let's just start hurling magic arrows and speed this up. Destroy undead? No. Oh. Have I ever played or heard of Disciples? No, actually. No, I have not. Just realized I forgot to resurrect my fallen skeleton in that last fight. $2,000 gold. And that's why we went to the stat boosts, so our Walking Dead could survive hits from Silver Pegasi. And so we could do that. Death Ribble! Good news is, for the vast majority of this map, we don't have to care about what the AI is doing, because it is of no concern to us. They actually lived. There's the magic wall. Alright, through several war unicorns. This is where I regret not picking up Chain Lightning with Freedomina, but I know we're trying to finish this up. First thing is I'm assuming this was saying Necrowing, and if that's in relation to spawning, to farming a bunch of skeletons, then the answer is yes, that is the first thing I will be doing. And how I will be focusing the completion of this scenario. Oh, what? Of course. I don't have, animate that. Interesting. Sandra, you went the wrong way. Alright, 113, 4. And we take the garrison next turn, I hope. Should be the same as the other one. I will not need another walkthrough, Rito. I've taken care of that. Thank you. Have a good night. And thank you again for the first one. Or, I should say, my chat absolutely will thank you again for the first one. That all of the fights involve magic dampers. I can only assume that that's on purpose. Maybe I shouldn't have done that. Hashtag one wood, of course. This is the same fight. Yeah, no, this is actually different. Potentially more deadly. Fuck sleep, yeah, absolutely. Are there any maps that automatically start with levels? Seems a lot more fun to have some levels to play around with early on. I'm not sure what you mean. Start with levels? I don't have teleport. All of those mage guilds, and we couldn't get teleport. Got a lot. Thank you, 3DO. Well, we might have actually gotten teleport, but again, for the sake of time, we just sped it up, and this is what happens. Then no, I don't think there are any that will actually start with levels. Or, I'm sure if you look around, there are some single scenarios that do. I couldn't name one off the top of my head. But it probably exists, now that I think about it. please. Alright, hit them too. Oh, the ballista! Alright. Phew, saved ourselves with that one. Ten times ten is 100. Five times five is... Alright. That was on purpose. That wasn't, but alright. There we go. Charge. Why isn't there a HOM creature randomizer? That would be interesting. That would certainly be an interesting twist. We have enough mana. I believe this is the last fight in this general vicinity. Alright, just... No losses, alright. Alright, so is that side done? We have to build this eventually, so I guess I'll build it now. You have discovered why the Kreegans have not gotten the ring back. A powerful druid named Melodia has captured the item and dug herself into a very secure location. Using her powerful magic, Melodia has created a series of teleporters to keep intruders out. The ring is rumored to always be on her person. 0 out of 10. 30th level crag hack with ballista. Oh, dude. And artillery. I mean, you guys saw how broken that crap was. I had that on full display. I need him out here. Of ore. get them both. Unfortunately, I won't be able to do much more because the game is just killing me right now. So there she is. Elfwind and Melodia. Wraith Tower unreachable? Nope. I just didn't take it with Ezra because I knew I could get another hero out there. And didn't really want to waste the movement at the time. That's gonna be interesting. Don't know if I want to save that fight for Vampire Lords or not. Probably should. Alright, Summies, thank you very much for coming. Have a good one. Yo, Ghost, you wanna try and be a skeleton? Yeah. Thought it was level 40, Craig. We got him up to, what, 40? Yeah, we got him up to 40. He didn't level up again. That I remember. Maybe 41? Skeletons. That should be doable. After all the other fights I've taken. Hey, Gagasha. Is this a 24-hour marathon? No, because I have work tomorrow. All dedicated to the last campaign of Shadow of Death. Yep. I had to give it its nice little send-off, you know? I have no idea what's in this garrison. So what I'm actually going to do is... Wait. Do I have visions? Of course not. So I'm actually going to save Shadow of Death 2. Then I'm going to go delete these other saves, because I don't actually want them there anymore. Ooh, what the hell? Why is that the garrison? What? Why? Alright, well, I'm gonna wait for Vampire Lords to do that. And that's purely for time, so that we're not wasting time and losing units when I don't have to. Vampire growth is 8. Da-da-da. If I had done one, yes, I would have been at ROE right now. I'll still do ROE tonight, it's only 10 o'clock. Those are not Vampire Lords, I know. It's like to speedrun this game. Lol. Who's fuck's Sladwick? Is it not me? I know they're not Vampire Lights. We'll be fine without Vampire Lights. just have those ready for next time. Sandro! I'll do you now. The scouting party returned early in the morning. They were too slow to catch the silver Pegasi flying overhead from the direction of the rampart town where Melodia resides. If they took a message to the other Avalley lords, you will soon face more than just a single druid. And are we to take Stannis, Jem, Crag, and Sandro as heroes? If only. We will have Stannis. This is going... It's going to be, ROE is going to be when King Stannis reconquers Arathia. Too expensive. Skeletons. That's gotta be enough. I'll take it. 114 is our reward. I'll take it because I don't see myself actually doing better. 66 skeletons. Could use those here too. Recruit skeletons, but I'd rather be recruiting vampires from the external vampire dwellings, to be perfectly honest. Alright, Isra. Here we go. So Fiona and Clancy and Yacht, the dream team, yeah. That would be quite funny if we actually did that. We're not, so don't get your hopes up. I don't know why I even split these up anymore. How do they get only lose two of these? I guess that's enough. Hasten them, they're still not fasting. They are fasting, alright. It up in the last one. Oh, they tried. was the level I was allowed to reach? 24? I guess I'll see if I reach that on the final fight. It is always best to know your enemy, which is why you often use spies to find out what you can about them, especially this druid. It will be a few days before the spy returns. If I remember this mission, this scenario correctly, it takes a lot more than a few days for that spy to return. Again, since the other heroes don't actually carry over like it says, I'm not gonna worry about buffing them. The only hero who would get the buffs is Sandro, and if Sandro had a necromancy specialty that these two did, specifically Isra and Redoman, then I would be using him. But alas, he does not. Now there is a point of no return here. Alright, pack of rocks. Bold strategy. They went for the ballista. I won't care about that then. This will be most useful against those far too happy rangers. And you know what, game? I couldn't agree more. Is it time to kill Skrillodia? No. Pack of rocks. Yeah. You're a goofy goober. Rocks. Too happy rangers, yes. Too happy. Medusa Queen. I don't know. Sandro bops so hard he forgot necromancy. No, it's just not worth getting on him. He's just got extra necromancy, which is 40% right now, whereas these guys are 5% level bonus. So 5 times 18 is 50. I know it doesn't work exactly like that, but like you can just see where it's gonna start rolling along. Rolling, 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 rolling. Dave and I like to sing. Pack of kings. Did someone say Sandro? Did someone say the big one? that's where we've gone too far. To use Vidomina to test that theory. I returned today. The news was not good. Or at least that's what you gather from the dismembered corpse tossed on your front doorstep in the pre-dawn hours. It would be extremely prudent to learn more about this mysterious druid. Mighty moves. Right, and then that will lead us right over to Vidomina. Which is obviously not where we're looking to go. And there she is. Horde pack, horde throng pack, lots, and whatever else is in Elfwind. 1137. What's nice is that the AI does not have a way to get dragons right off the bat, so their army won't be as large as it could be. What's not good is that we're screwed for gold right now. That I mean, we literally have none. There's obviously a travel gate, but it no longer appears to be functioning. Well, there's that. Like a trading post or something. Fortunately, there's not, so there's the capital. Now, I don't remember how long we actually have. TPDD, we have neither of those things. I mean, if we had Dimension Door, I'm pretty sure you could just do the scenario in 111. Maybe 112? Nah, 111. Definitely 111. Let's upgrade those, and let's upgrade those for the final fights. We got 468 skeletons just clearing the map. Should be about 500 when we eventually kill those. Ah, I see the point of the refugee camps. It's in case you got a town portal and wanted to actually sacrifice skeletons. That's interesting, actually. But, you know, it's not worth sitting over there with Thanis. Let's go over here with Isra and keep and chain back the vampire lords. You must move quickly or face overwhelming odds. If you do not complete your mission in the next 2 months, then the Avli forces will have time to organize and drive you permanently from this realm of existence. It is essential to get the ring and leave the area as quickly as possible. Alright, so I'll assume that means I only have until 347. Then again, the game could be crushed and just screw us over, so I believe he has expert logistics, right? Yes. Fortunately, I went through there with Vidomina, so I can't use her. I would hire another hero, but I'd like to conserve one. Alright, I will, but not this turn. And I don't see any. Ah, there we go. Three-month limit on small map, yeah. No, it's not a problem. I do remember that the first time I played this, though, I was purposely passing days for army, and I didn't realize that there's actually a time limit, because that's the only time it tells you. So that was a funny loss. Oh, some right there as well. Alright, Ezra. We'll get him. $15,000 right there. I don't think we'll actually hit level 24 with Sandra. If we tried, we could probably hit it with Ezra, but... I'm obviously not going to be doing that. It is always good to know someone who will retain and sell information. Fortunately, you know such a person, a thief named Deathmar, who makes it his business to know about the background of all who dwell in these lands. Jotting down a little of the little you know, or a little of what you know, about the Druid Melodia, you send off the parchment via a dead crow. Again, that's another reason I'm just letting the army build right now instead of rushing at Melodia. I would like to actually read all the text cutscenes since we've come this far already. In the campaigns. And there's no reason not to. And 21 more. I totally store the units in the garrison if I can take them out of the garrison. Unfortunately, that's not something we're allowed to do. No, accrued over 500 skeletons before even marching. Can refugee camps give azures? Nope. Yeah, they only go up to level 7. Upgraded level 7s, which is pretty nice, but still only level 7. Otherwise, I'd probably be checking them to see if they did. Yep, 500 good skeletons. Again, if I was really interested, I could probably attack her right now and win. But again, I'm not playing for the win here, I'm playing for the test cutscenes right now. Text cutscenes, not test cutscenes. Actually recruit the entire army. 52, 37, 56. Actually, we were. How about that? We even recruited some more. Dun, 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 dun. 813 skeletons. Yeah, you can get sharpshooters and chancer. You can get all the neutral units as well, other than those higher level dragons. Alright, let's do it. Pretty sure the last text scene will come up as we're on our way over. Went there, right? Went there, went there, went there. Went there, very nice. Here we go. Yep. Just keep a skeleton. Did I have him? Keep a vampire lord. It was dumb. Oh boy. Here we go. Just came up. Deathmar has obtained some history on the druid. His price for revealing it to you is steep. 3,000 gold and 4 sulfur. You send off the payment, hoping the information will be worth such a lofty sum. Soon afterwards, Deathmar sends the following message in reply. Greetings, Sandra. Melodia is a veteran hero of Avalon. That she has survived so many battles suggests she is lucky to say the least. She has powerful magical abilities with a full complement of spells in her repertoire. Any magic user would salivate to have even the briefest peek at her spellbook. Oh, is that all we're looking at? Her reputed skills are excellent, with her having mastered the 4 magical arts as well as studying combat tactics. She has picked up more than just a pathetic ever-smoking ring of sulfur in her travels. I am surprised you are not after the sandals of the saint, the armor of wonder, the golden bow, or the hellstorm helmet. All rumored to be in her possession. If you choose to go up against this formidable druid, I suggest you have plenty of troops under your command. Deathmar. Okay, so to translate, she's highly leveled. She has full spells, and probably sorcery and wisdom. She has all four magic skills at expert. She has those artifacts, which speaks for itself. And of course, she has tactics. And luck. Spell power at this point. Yeah, war unicorns. Use war unicorns against it. Hail Hydra. Because why not? So watch out for Mass Fortune. Yep, that I think that's what that meant. Kill some Mighty Gorgons. I don't think so. Alright, I will not use mana if I can get away with it here. Expert everything now. Level 20 Sandro. We can get up to level 24, but I don't think we're going to. What lies beyond? Oh. It may be that we shall lose this fight. It may even be true. Maybe not, maybe not. That's not as large as it looked. It's a lot, don't get me wrong. 170 out of 170, 10, 12, 10, 17. Town portal. Raquel, oh boy, a titan. Oh yeah, we're getting that titan. Hold on. Actually, keep him, why not? Oh, I didn't get him. Alright, just in case, let's do this. 7 stacks, I should have saved. Now we can lose! No. I think we got this. Hopefully she stays in her town. Alright, good. Save the game. Shadow of Death 2. Take Timmy the Titan, sit outside the castle for one turn since we ran out of movement, and let's begin the end.
Zealots OP.
Throng, horde, throng, swarm, lots, horde, several, charge. Okay. She has no fear. Air shield? That's fine, I wasn't intending to cast many spells. Especially more worried about hurt units, but okay. Alright, let's follow our usual plan of action. Oh god! He died already! Oh, I thought none of them died. I was like, you've got to be kidding me. Thank you. No. I wasn't trying to lure Melodia out. I'm actually glad we are fighting here. It's supposed to be fought in the town. If I wanted to lure her out, you stick one of the heroes under the Shrine of Magic, because then she can't actually get back. Wouldn't it be awesome to have Cloak of the Stannis King? Yeah, and Armor of the Stannis, absolutely. Yeah, man. That air shield, putting in gains against those lizardmen. Watch out. Ooh, look at that expert luck. Feel that expert luck in your unicorn bones. And let's just do this. Nice defensive maneuver. Protection from it? Oh. Rip Hydra. Live with that. Gonna take out the gold dragons or not. Alright, I'll wait with those. Now let's take out the gold dragons. Well, close enough. No! Get off my- Oh god! 22 rose from the dead. Holy crap. Alright, next turn we're gonna be Hastings, so that's fine. Yeah. I'd say our Vampire Lord's probably be good enough. Oh, no! He saw right through my plans. No! My skeletons! Double damage, of course not. often is it ever double damage. I like how I'm actually able to do some sort of damage with that. Oof. Yeah, I think I can win this. Fairly certain I will win this, unless she pulls out a freaking implosion here. Oh, of course. Well, I was just going for it anyway. Double damage. Never. Never double damage. Haha! I called it. Can't say I didn't call it. Alright, so, if that's what you have, this is what I have. There's still a lot to be bound, how about that? Waiting for the dispel, but I'll counter that when it comes. There we go. Rip all those skeletons. Oh, it hurts. Oh, God. We have so many, but we won. I'm trying to do an implosion with BM here. There's the double damage. Take that. Oh no. No. Okay. We got him. And you're dead. Thanks for playing, Melodia. You gave it a good effort. Pew, pew, pew. There's the win. Alright, we've 669. What a fight. We did not hit level 24, or would have said so. Oh, and there you go. Elfstorm Helmet, Centaur's Axe, Shield of the Dwarven Lords, Armor of Wonder, Golden Bow, Bow of Avancharia Wood, Sandals of the Saint, and Eversmoking Ring of Soul. Only one level, level 21. 349 skeletons. And we have defeated Melodia. The final scenario. This is it.